Delron Buckley has had an illustrious football career after playing for South Africa 73 times and Borussia Dortmund 61 times. The attacking midfield has had incredible successes on the pitch, but also has made amazing strides in dealing with his own mental health off the pitch. Buckley had difficulties travelling to a foreign country at a young age and managing the titanic expectations thrust upon him. Buckley spoke to Varsity Sports about these trying times and gave advice to other athletes on how to navigate through the pressures and anxieties that come with high-level sports.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. So in terms of like when you went to Dortmund and the pressure from everything around it, the crowd, that affected your game. So, and I suppose the most obvious question is, why is mental health important with athletes, with anyone?
The reason why it's important, because as an athlete, when you come to such an elite level, all right, and there's a lot of determination put into the sport regarding people that are probably purchasing you for millions and millions of euros or rands to come and play for them. And then what happens is that the pressure is enormous, because the people that are putting all their, the clubs, you know, putting their money into you, expect things that you need to come and produce. And if you don't, it falls into such a situation where you don't know how to get out of it, because now you expect in mind, you know, you're getting, you've probably been bought for a lot of money or you pay a lot of money, but you're not producing.
Sure.
And that becomes a mental problem. And that's the problem that I had.
Sure.
When I went to Borussia Dortmund, that's why I say to many athletes, it's very important in your life when you are athlete and you're progressing, it's always nice to have someone to mentor you. You know, to tell you, look, this is life, doesn't matter, but you're gonna come back.
Sure.
You know, you're all gonna come back and you're all gonna produce and you're all gonna keep on going. And I didn't have that.
Sure.
I didn't have that. I went straight from with the age of 16 to Germany. I got implemented the development of the German system and so on, but the club didn't have at the time highly qualified mentors to mentor players.
Yeah,
you know. But now, if you go to Germany, believe it or not, I think Borussia Dortmund has a mentor for every single team.
Sure.
From under sevens all the way up to the first team. Yeah.
I mean, it's fascinating because, I mean, sports psychology is becoming bigger and bigger. And I remember, like, Jake White spoke about having a sports psychologist when they won the World Cup. And then now, even at the Varsity Sevens, Stellenbosch had a mental coach with their team, which is incredible. So obviously, it's more and more important to speak to someone about these kind of things, which kind of leads me to my next question. When someone is going through that kind of anxiety or frustration, why is it important for someone to speak up or speak to someone else?
You know, I can only speak from my experience.
Sure, no, of course.
When I went through that dark hole, I had no one to speak to. So I don't know which way to get out of all this mess that was happening. And when you have a mentor that's there and, can mentor you in a proper way, these people, you know, they actually motivate you of not taking the wrong direction.
Sure.
You know, of doing the right thing. And be patient about it, because it is going to turn. It's not going to stay forever. And that's a guarantee. Yeah. So, to have these guys, you know, they're like there to motivate you. Ask them to motivate you, to pick you up. Because you are down. You are in a big hole. To pick you up, raise you, and say, look, you are the best. Just keep on doing what you do best. And don't worry about it. And then push on. Because the athlete can only reach to a certain extent, but cannot push themselves the next level without any help of a mentor or anything. And I think that's a big factor.
Sure. And I mean, on a lower level, obviously we're not talking about kind of Bayern Munich or Barcelona. We're talking about kind of Varsity football or your local club team, or anyone, I suppose, who's suffering from mental struggles or going through something. Who should people be speaking to, do you think? If it's not a mentor, is it a parent? Is it a brother? Do you think that's the same sort of thing?
Well, you know, all these problems come with different, genders. All right, like if you play in the top level, of course, I went to Dortmund, as I said, I was bought for so much money, I had to produce. I did it, which I fell into a big hole. You're talking about universities or small clubs. There's athletes that come with different problems, maybe at home, these things were happening at home, and then it fixed their sports. When they come, they can't concentrate properly. And then what happens, the coach sees, okay, this child is, this athlete is not producing, and puts more pressure on and more. That's a whole different ball game of type of mental pressure.
Mm.
You understand?
Sure.
And it's very hard. It's very hard because, you know, as I say, at the elite level, now you have people there at clubs mentoring you. But at the bottom level, it's difficult because who do you talk? That is the problem. Who do you talk to? Who can you trust?
Sure.
Because you're living in a world of a society where you can't trust anyone.
Yeah, sure.
You understand? You can't trust anyone. The minute you tell someone something,
they
won't tell the next person. Then the whole world knows that probably Delron Buckley has a mental problem or is depressed or so on.
Sure.
So that's why athletes, playing at not top level, they're really careful.
Yeah.
You know, just to put it, I would just say that they should just try find someone where they can trust, or find someone, maybe in a mentor that's willing to help, you know, for free. Because I know at the day, these youngsters can't afford motivational speakers and all.
Or like a psychologist.
They're really expensive. Exactly.
Exactly. Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. So it's a challenge for those, right? I mean, playing at amateur level. It's a big challenge.
Sure. And I mean, the whole Speak Up campaign is about trying to break that stigma. So if you were to tell someone and said, like, listen, Nick is going through things right now, he's got depression, he's got anxiety, that someone doesn't say, like, oh, let me tell someone because that's something that's bad. Let me help Nick. You know what I mean? I suppose that's what we're trying to do. I suppose through your playing days, when you were going through, I suppose, that anxiety or frustration, what did you do to get into the right headspace? Was there someone, if it wasn't talking to a mentor, was it, I don't know, listening to music or getting back in the field or something like that?
I mean, before I became a professional, when I played in South Africa, and when I left in 94, I was 16 years old. I just had my mindset on just to enjoy the game.
Sure.
Because when I was playing, there was no money involved. You understand?
Yeah.
I was playing for free and I was enjoying my football. Of course, I had my problems regarding school, maybe family problems, maybe other problems, but I tried not to these problems to affect me. I did have lots of friends where I could speak about. But as I said, I was very careful about speaking about anything. You know, and I just had one thing in my head, that I want to be a professional footballer. And in the day, nothing's going to stop me.
Yeah.
You know, it's my only chance to get out of where I grew up. Because if I don't make it, then I was going to probably end up be a gangster,
sure,
or be one of the drug dealers, who knows? I'll probably be dead by now.
Yeah, sure.
You see, but I knew this because in the environment I grew up, I knew that if I don't make it out of here, then, you know, how long do I know I'm going to, how many years will I know I'm going to live?
Sure.
So that kept me motivated to keep on going, keep on trying, keep on working hard.
Yeah. And I mean, even after you made it, like even when you were, like you went over to Germany, 16, you went to Switzerland to play. I mean, so like, I mean, now you can regard yourself as a success regardless, but you still felt those issues. So, I mean, what did you do then? Was it a turning to someone? Was it listening to music? You know what I mean? That kind of thing. Like, is it obviously that stress affects you no matter whether you're coming from where you grew up or whether you're playing at the highest level?
Well, when I first went to Germany, it was 94. I was still becoming a professional footballer. I had no family that side, and the first 2 years in Germany was really difficult. You know, that's another mental depression that I went through, because I was living with a German family that couldn't speak English, a word of English. So the communication was hands and feet. Can you believe it?
No way.
And I'm
drawing pictures
about a year.
Yeah.
So there was also mentally draining for me that after every training session, I knew I'm going to have to come home to this family that they took me as one of their family members, but they couldn't speak a word of English.
Yeah.
It's, you know, so it was either make or break. But the good thing, as the years went past and I started, you know, I signed my first professional contract, started scoring, started getting recognized in Germany. Then I met my wife. Yeah. And that was another pat on my shoulder, because when she came into my life, you know, things even got, not the marriage or her, but football-wise, got even more worse, because you get more famous, you earn more money, you drive nice cars, and people are really jealous of you driving maybe a Porsche and a Ferrari around and earning big money. So then my friend circle became very, very small.
Yeah.
And the only friend circle I had was my wife.
Sure.
And there was days when I used to come home and if I didn't play, the coach puts me on the bench. And then she was the one that used to cheer me up.
Yeah.
You know, and then of course when my first daughter was born, it was a different story.
Mm.
You know, I mean, the minute you come home, you had a bad day, you see your daughter there, everything just blocks out and changes.
Sure.
You know, and makes you realize, you know, because of this, you need to keep on going, keep on going, keep on carry on, don't give up.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, is that the advice you would give to young athletes from varsity football to school level? Or anyone trying to make it, is that the advice you would give to someone who may be going through not mental illness, but maybe not?
You know,
is that the advice you would give?
Whenever I do motivational talking, just a few weeks ago, there was some big athlete convention here at Moses Mabhida, and I speak there.
Yeah.
And lots of young athletes, top South African athletes, runners, hockey players, you name it.
Yeah.
And then they asked me the same question which you asked.
Yeah.
And I said to him, one thing you must realize, okay, that your career is going to come to an end.
Sure.
So don't think it's going to go forever and ever.
Mm.
But you have just a small time frame of to have as much fun as possible and enjoy as much as possible. And in this time phase, if you're going through depression, don't be scared to speak it out. Don't be scared to ask for help.
No.
You know, the best thing is, as I said, if on the high elite level, you always have mental coaches that work in that little circle of, if you're playing for South Africa, or like the high performance center, you have on Moses Mabhida, they have a doctor, Dr. Subin, that these kids can go to speak to him and he can refer to someone to help and so on.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? But they should not keep it in, because if you don't talk about it, it's going to affect you big time.
Sure.
It'll even affect you that you will come to such a situation where you want to commit suicide.
Mm.
And believe it or not, I never even thought that would happen to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I was almost close. Yeah. On taking my life, very, very close.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Massively difficult.
And I thought it'll never ever happen. When things were happening, you know, when I was scoring and everything was just happening for me, I never in my whole entire life that I would fall into such a deep mental depression.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
But it can happen overnight.
Yeah. Sure. I mean, that's fascinating. I mean, like, I love that story about that thing when you were at Dortmund and they were booing you, and then you kind of came back and then they were singing you happy birthday for you. Just like the most incredible story. Like, that must have been amazing. I mean, was it for you, was it like, and I don't know if this is for the interview or my own interest, but was it like a I am that good, you should have never underestimated me? Like, was it a moment like that?
Yeah, it was a big moment, you know, and that's why I put in my book, to make people realize that, you know, things can turn.
Sure.
I don't think, because now at this time things are going wrong, things can turn. And that's why I wanted to prove the people in Dortmund that although I had a bad season, I was depressed, I wasn't scoring, the fans were booing at me,
yeah,
I had to just leave for a second to get my head free. Then when I came back, tables had turned, and tables do turn. And if I go to Dortmund, they will give me VIP tickets to watch in any game I want to.
Sure.
And the fans, they love me.
Amazing.
You see, so things do turn.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Oh, that's the name of this article, I think. Things do turn. That's beautiful.
Things do turn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
don't think it doesn't. Because it's just like a storm. You know, if a storm comes, it's not going to be a storm for a whole 12 months.
Yeah.
A storm will come for 1 or 2 days, but it's going to end. And what comes after the storm? The sunlight.
Sure.
Yeah.
No, fantastic. Thank you so much, Delron. You should have a podcast.
Not a
Why don't you have a podcast?
Sorry?
You should have a podcast. This would be brilliant. Honestly, I think you should do it.
Yeah. We'll see what happens. Okay. Who knows? Maybe it'll happen.
But anyway, thank you so much for this. I really, really appreciate your time.
Bro.
Thank you, man.
No problem.
And good luck with the clinic. I hope everything goes well. I heard you've got ambitions to be the next Bafana coach.
Yes, of course I do. But I want to do my coaching badges first before I take that coach.
Earn your stripes.
But it will happen.
But I think we need you at the moment, because a 0-0 draw to Seychelles is not something to write home about.
Yeah, I saw the game. Wasn't pleasant, eh? Yeah. Wasn't pleasant.
No, it wasn't. Anyway. But yeah, thank you so much, man. I really appreciate
Anytime,
it.
Anytime, Nick.
See you.
Okay. Cheers.
Bye.
Cheers, man.
Bye.
Okay, bye.